quintessential song, hymn, whatever, okay, that has to do with Christmas, and that is Silent Night, okay? Now, Silent Night has an interesting story behind it. First of all, the poem of Silent Night was written in 1816 by a young priest in Austria by the name of Joseph Mohr, M-O-H-R, okay, not long after the Napoleonic Wars had taken their toll. The backstory is that the priest went for a walk on a cold night in a town called Oberndorf, okay? And this is a town that's kind of on the border between Austria, Germany, and Switzerland, right? And there's an old wives' tale that the organist at the church wrote this piece because the rats had eaten the leathers away on the organ, and when they went to turn the organ on, all the pipes sounded. That's not true, okay? What is true is that the church flooded, and the whole church flooded, and the organ was flooded, and they didn't know what to do. And this priest, Joseph Mohr, had this poem, and he brought it to his organist at the church in 1818, Christmas Eve, gave it to him on Christmas Eve day, and said, "Will you write this for tonight?" And that's what he wrote. He wrote Silent Night. He was given about 8 hours notice, okay? And he had this poem, and he wrote Silent Night. And that's how this came to be. So think about that. You know, given this piece of poetry here, in 6 hours we have our service, write something. So he wrote something simple, and because it was simple, look what's happened. Because it's simple, it's been where it is forever and ever and ever. So here's Stille Nacht, Silent Night. Director for Rocky Horror Show at the charts that we had to show said that he couldn't do it. And lo and behold, in my email, I get an email from this guy that I don't know, from the man in the moon, by the name of Ed Hamilton. This is Ed Hamilton. And he said, buckle your seatbelts, folks, that he's been playing on Broadway for many, many years. He was the principal guitarist for the starting orchestra for over 30 Broadway shows. And played on the original Broadway cast album. So chances are, if you listen to several Broadway cast albums, you have heard him play, not unbeknownst to you. Well, anyway, I get this email from him, and he says, hey, do you need a guitarist? Well, come on, you kidding? The guitarist just quit. So I said, oh, okay, this is God helping me out. So I called Ed, and he came, and he played guitar, and he killed it. Well, then I became his friend, okay? And we decided to do this. But Ed and Hillary are here tonight, not because Ed plays guitar, because he's a great musician and all that. They're here because they're a mom and dad of a young man who plays cello, which is Liam, who's standing right back there. That's their principal reason for being here. That's what they're probably. Okay. I want to show you what Silent Night originally sounded like. Because remember, the church got flooded, so they couldn't use the organ. So Silent Night was never meant to be played, even though it's beautiful, by a full orchestra, by a piano. It was when Franz Gruber wrote the music, he wrote the music for classical guitar. Most people don't know that. And he wrote it as a duet for two men, himself and the priest, were singing it as a duet with the classical guitar. And guess what? There are six verses to it. I didn't know this. I thought there was only the three, right? Wait a minute, hold on a minute. We all know this. I have it here somewhere. Yeah, Silent Night, Holy Night, All is Calm, All is Bright. That's the first verse. Second verse, Silent Night, Holy Night, Shepherds Quake at the Side. That's the second verse. Silent Night, Holy Night, Son of God loves pure light. That's the one that we know as the third verse. Guess what? That's verses 1, 6, and 2. Oh. Yeah, we have never heard verses 3, 4, and 5 at all. Okay, I have them here. We're not going to do them tonight because we'd be here till May. So we're not going to do all six of them tonight. But we are going to do the piece the way it was originally written, which is different from how you know it. Ready? We know. That's where the similarity ends. It's different from that point on. We know. The original is. See how it matches with. Right? Then we know. Totally different rhythm. Okay? Now here's where it gets really interesting. We know. Actually, that's the harmony written up an octave higher. The real original tune is. And now, to make it sound like it's German and Austrian and Swiss. That's the original tune for it. So we are going to do it now the way it was originally written, on the instrument it was originally written for, in the original key it was written for. The only difference is Ed is not going to sing. Okay? So I'm going to sing, and we're going to do verses 1, 6, and 2. In other words, the three verses that you know as 1, 2, and 3. And he's going to be playing the accompaniment from the original way that Gruber wrote it. And the reason we know that is because I looked at a facsimile, a photo of the original one, and this is an exact copy of the original notes for the guitar. So here it is. Stilenach, like you probably have never heard it before. All right, this next piece, famous Leroy Anderson piece called Sleigh Ride, okay? And And Leroy Anderson composed in July 1946. July. He's in July and he's writing Christmas music. Okay? And finished it in February 1946. July 1946, and finished it in February 1948. So almost two years. Okay? It was originally instrumental. The lyrics where someone asked him to join them for a ride on a sleigh were written by Mitchell Parrish in 1950. So 2 years later, when the words were added. The orchestral version was originally recorded by Arthur Fiedler in the Boston Pops. Okay? And every year we do this sleigh ride, and I come just to hear Cheryl Lindley do the whinny of the horse. Okay? Which I am greatly looking forward to. So here's good old Leroy Anderson sleigh ride, complete with a whip and bells and every darn thing that there is. Off you go. Of music that's arranged for Christmas, okay? So if you ever wanted to find some piano music or some other instruments, she's written a lot of things for other instruments for Christmas music. Janine Yeager, she has written gobs of arrangements of Christmas music. And this young lady's name is Ailis, A-I-L-I-S. Ailis, where are you, honey? There you are, come on. Give her a round of applause. Your name? And she says, Ailis. And I said, okay, here's what I want you to remember. The next time somebody asks you how you pronounce your name, I want you to say, Ailis, like I'm on the A-list, baby. Okay? Okay? So she's going to remember that. I hope she remembers that she's on the A-list. She's on the A-list with me. So here's Joy of the World, arranged by Janine Yeager, performed by Miss Ailis. You're upset? Off you go.
Thank you.
you're 10 years old. 10 years old. Okay. And you don't know this, folks, but she wasn't reading off any music. That was from memory. Okay? Now, how long do you practice to play the piano each day? Sure, of course. But what do you think? What, do you play it every day or not every day? Honestly, tell me the truth. You play almost every day. And how long do you play? 30 minutes to 1 hour a day. Okay. So let's give her another hand. A half an hour to an hour every day. She doesn't practice 4 hours a day. She practices a half hour to an hour every day. Don't overdo it. If you want to get better, practice. If you practice, you'll play better music. If you play better music, you'll play with better players. If you play with better players, you'll want to get better like they are. And if you want to get better like they are, you'll practice, okay? Follow. Ready? If you want to get better, you practice. If you practice, you'll get play better music. If you play better music, you'll play with better players. If you play with better players, you'll want to get better like they are. And if you want to get better like they are, you practice. Excellent. Okay. That's dad. That's the dad yelling at me. Okay. Okay. Ayla, she did great, honey. Absolutely great. Now, the next piece, ready for this, is called Mozart in the Jingle. Not Mozart in the Jungle, Mozart in the Jingle. Now, I defy you to look up on your book, Mozart in the Jingle, and see if any of you can come up with any information on it, because you have to look through about 4,000 sites about Mozart in the Jungle before you find it. Okay? You do. Okay. Here's what it is. It's Eine kleine Nachtmusik and Magic Flute and Jingle Bells mushed into one, okay? Now, one of the things, kids, that you don't know is this. Mozart wrote a whole treatise about the importance of the rest. And I'm playing that music that you're gonna play. Imagine it like this. Doesn't have any life. Now you put the rest in. Bum, bum, bum. See how important the rests are? Mozart said that the music happens in between the notes. Think about that. So play it. Here you go. piece is a piece by Andrew Lloyd Webber. Now, anybody who knows me as a music director for musicals here on Maui knows that if they're ever going to do a musical and it's by Andrew Lloyd Webber, chances are I'm not going to do it because he's not one of my favorite composers, okay? But he wrote a requiem, and in this requiem, if you go home and listen to it, it's really not good. But there's one movement from it that's terrific, and that's the PAAs, and you're going to hear the PAAs now. If you don't believe me, go home and listen to the whole thing. You're going to go say, yeah, he's right. This is the only good thing from it. So this is the PAAs. It's written for two sopranos, chorus, and organ, or two sopranos, chorus, and orchestra. So this it's a lovely piece. The PAAs from Andrew Lloyd Webber's record.
Thank you.
Our finale tonight is a bunch of things, but one of the things that you might recognize is the tune from the St. Paul Suite by Gustav Holst. Is one of the main themes that's in this finale. So this is our last hurrah tonight. Thank you all for being here and coming and supporting our string players. It means the world that you're here. It really does. So thank you.
That's just how it is. Cheryl. Up there, out there. Oh, Eric.
We're out here.
I can't believe it, the whole crew and pull us back. What an honor.
How you doing?
I can't believe it. It's like,
you survived.
You too. Yeah, somehow we made it, right? Right, totally. Sweet, man. Great to see you guys. You looks like sore eyes.
Yeah.
We like a vision from another world.
Oh, this is good.
Sweet.
I love it.
You guys are awesome. Is everyone today? No surprise.
Yeah. You doing good too?
Oh, yeah. Lots of fun people.
You got some stuff going.
Yeah, yeah. I'm trying to get it to you, man.
Maybe
call. Yeah.
All right.